Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So this week I haven't really done a lot of work on Gladiator Hoppers because, to be honest, I've hit kind of like a wall in development, and sometimes that happens and I just needed some time to breathe here for a moment. So I thought, instead of just staring at the screen and getting nothing done, why don't I try to make a game from start to finish in 3 days? So that's kind of what I did. So what you're seeing here is as far as I got after 3 days of development. Now, when I say that I finished the game, what I mean is that the game has a beginning, an end, and everything in between. It's obviously not a polished game yet, it's missing sound, and the art is all just placeholder, but I have hired a pixel artist who is currently working on the art, and I'll link to his Twitter in the description below if you want to check out his work, because he's very talented. But the reason I did this was to kind of prove to myself that I'm able to create something with limited scope without falling into the typical development trap of adding too many features right away. So I started out with an idea that I already had, and it was based on a game that I created in the past. So I thought it would be cool to kind of recreate this in a different setting. I figured jumping wizards would be a cool thing to do, and I had this vision of kind of a cute style of pixel art to go with it. Obviously, because I knew what my idea was already, and because I also knew that the idea would work, seeing as I had already created a similar game, it was much easier for me to actually make progress very quickly. But pretty soon I started getting annoyed at seeing this temporary background that I set up, so I changed the colors a bit and I added a wall on either side where the magic spells would hit and despawn in. I also made it so that when you held the button down, your character would slow down in the air, but I ditched that idea pretty fast since it felt unintuitive. Instead, I made it so that you can charge for a stronger attack whenever you tap and hold the button. So at this point, the gravity was way too weak and the characters felt too floaty, so I increased the gravity and the game went from feeling kind of bad to actually being pretty enjoyable to play. I made a simple AI script, a new background, and some buttons as well. I finished the whole game loop so that you could restart the game after one player had won. So up until now, there was no real way of telling whether your character hit the enemy or not. The spell despawned obviously, but there was no visible feedback on the screen, so I tried making the character being hit flash red, but I didn't really like it that much, so I changed it to black later on. I also implemented a HUD that shows your health and your mana. The idea I had with charging for a more powerful attack is that it will count down your mana and deal the same amount of damage as the amount of mana that you used for your attack. So finally, I added the main menu and tweaked some smaller things here and there, but now the things that are missing is the art, obviously, which I showed you a work in progress of before, and sound and music. I will probably get someone to create the music, but the sound effects I will make myself sometime in the future. So to conclude this video, it was a lot of fun doing something like this, and I think I'll make it a regular thing that I do every once in a while, maybe every month or every other month, just creating a small game in a couple of days as a practice. I hope you found it a bit interesting as well, but next time I'll get back to working on Gladiator Hoppers. So as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.